The 90-day fiancé star, Karine, won against Paul during a recent court case, and I'll tell you all about it. According to Starcasm, a Kentucky Court of Appeals upheld a restraining order taken out against 90-day fiancé star Paul by his then-wife, Karine. This decision was made public and it revealed some shocking details about Paul and Karine's marriage. It all started when Karine filed an emergency protection order against Paul on December 30th, 2021. This was around the same time they were getting divorced. In response, Paul filed his own two petitions for emergency protection against Karine. So the Kentucky courts upheld the protection order for Karine for a period of 3 years and also added other restrictions on Paul, including barring him from owning a firearm. Paul had appealed this court's decision before and said that the court had erroneously determined that he committed these acts of domestic violence against his wife and improperly found that she's at risk of future acts of domestic violence. But after the court heard Karine's side of the story, it seems they were not buying any of what Paul was saying. So here's what Karine said in support of her case against Paul in January of this year. And I have to warn you, some of the things Paul did to Karine were very serious, so if you can't handle, you can just skip. According to court documents, Karine alleged that Paul forced her to have intercourse without her consent multiple times, video recorded these encounters, and posted them online. Not only that, she also said that Paul threatened to deport her and also threatened to sell her into prostitution. Karine also said Paul once forcefully used a plastic penis without her permission and continued to do so despite her crying and asking him to stop, and claimed that in order to facilitate his abuse, Paul used drugs and alcohol on her. So the court looked at this and saw how Karine was really suffering in the marriage and decided to uphold her protection order from Paul. So during the January 18th hearing, Paul flatly denied the claims of sexual and emotional abuse on his wife, but his reasoning was very questionable. So according to Paul, the house was equipped with cameras and lighting, of course, for 90-day fiancé, and much of what they did was acting or drama for the cameras. But I don't remember any part of 90-day fiancé where they would show any of this, so Paul's reasoning isn't quite right. It doesn't make any sense, because 90 Day Fiancé is a show about a married couple, not much about the things Paul clearly is interested in, which is very disgusting. So here's the full ruling. The circuit court found Karine's claims of sexual abuse to be credible, i.e. more likely than not to be true. Findings of domestic violence is supported by the record and the law and is sufficient to sustain the DVO. Accordingly, we find no error and affirm that the order of the Jefferson Circuit Court, which stated that Paul should stay away from Karine for the next 3 years. Now, we all remember I had reported that Paul and Karine had lost custody of their two children and they were now in child protective services and being cared for by foster parents. So it seemed that the two lost the children after they were fighting. That's how Paul ended up with Pierre in another state and Karine ended up with no kids. 2 days before Paul had gone missing with Pierre, as you remember, TMZ and all the other blogs had reported that Paul had gone missing with his eldest son, Pierre. Karine had posted videos to her social media where one shows she had a bite mark from Paul and another shows Pierre in a tiny room crying. More proof that Paul was abusive to Karine is that Paul later admitted in a live interview that he did bite Karine's arm. He said he did this while driving because Karine allegedly grabbed the steering wheel and tried to steer them into oncoming traffic. So in order to stop her, he had to bite her arm. And then later, he kicked her out of the car and made her walk home. That was the last time Paul and Karine saw each other. And that was when Paul left the state with his son, Pierre. As I had earlier reported, Paul is now in Brazil and it seems he ran away to the country because he has some active warrants in Kentucky. After Paul had handed Pierre over to his mother and he ended up in child protective services, Paul made sure to flee the country. So what do you guys think? Because Paul keeps posting on social media about how much fun he's having in Brazil. So he's clearly not bothered, but who am I to judge? Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Thank you for watching.